Hey guys, in this video I'm going to be taking a quick dive into Creality's Sonic Pad. I'm going to be giving you my thoughts, pros, cons, my last month and a half of experience using it, and who I think this is for. So if you're interested in this, please stick around and I'm going to get right into it. Okay, so this is the 7-inch Sonic Pad that came out from Creality a couple of months ago. It's marketed as a plug-and-play option for getting Clipper up and running on your 3D printer, as opposed to using a Raspberry Pi, which takes some getting used to, a little bit of know-how. The manual is very, very straightforward. Installation of this product is very straightforward on your 3D printer. You get Clipper up and running. You can use Moonraker. And you can use your 3D printer straight from your PC. The truth is, I personally was trying to use Octoprint, but because of the price of Raspberry Pis, I kind of just didn't get into it. I don't do 3D printing as my full-time job. I use 3D printing as a hobby and fixing stuff up around the house and making small products to sell around my community. But aside from that, I don't really do this professionally. It took a little bit too much time to kind of fiddle around with it, so I just kind of left that alone and I kept using my SD card to upload files on my 3D printer and printing them directly from the SD card. So when I found out about this option from Creality, I decided that this might be something I'd like to get into. I got the Creality Sonic Pad about a month and a half ago. I've been using it since. I'm pretty excited about it, but there are some drawbacks. All right, so there's three major pros. First, I'm gonna start out with speed, which is marketed as the number one pro for getting the Sonic Pad, because essentially Creality is trying to market this as a way to speed up your printing ability while keeping the quality of your 3D prints relatively standard. I've found that is the case for sure. You can definitely speed up your 3D printing with this. It really helps out with that. However, it's not as plug and play to get your speed up as you might think it is. Pro number two, being able to use a nice large touchpad on your 3D printer. I know not all of you have a touch screen on your 3D printer, and even if you do, this one is far more comfortable to use, easy to use, and a lot bigger, you know? And there's a lot more options on here than there are, even on my Ender 3S 1 Pro comes with a really nice touch screen. This beats that out of the park. The third pro, I would say, is the biggest pro for me, the ability to use my 3D printer via my computer and via my phone whenever I want to, straight out of the box. I don't have to set up Octoprint. I was using Octoprint for a while on a phone. It's kind of difficult to connect the phone to your 3D printer and to the power at the same time, so I was having a little bit of issues with the Octoprint on the phone. This changed all of that. Now I can use my 3D printer straight from my computer. I have a million options. It's super simple to use. It's really straightforward. I love it, and I'm very excited about that. That is my number one pro for this Sonic Pad. Now for the cons. First of all, this Sonic Pad is marketed as being out of the box, plug and play, straight up upgrade your 3D printing. That is not 100% the case. There are tweaks. There's not I wouldn't say it's a steep learning curve, but there is a learning curve that involved with this. There are slicer settings that need to be changed. You have to kind of learn how to use this properly to be able to get the most out of it. There are some settings that will allow you to really boost your 3D printing, but there is, again, a learning curve, and there's tons of videos about that out there. If you'd like me to make a video getting into the ins and outs of how to do the resonance testing and a whole bunch of other things, you can leave a comment down below. I'd love to help get that content out to you guys, whatever you like. That reminds me, if you guys are getting any kind of value out of this video, I would really appreciate a like, comment, and subscribe. That would help me out so much. Anyway, let's get back into it. So the second con that I found was having these little legs. The way that Creality set this tablet up to be used on the 3D printer is essentially you have these little kickstand legs that come out, okay? you have these little kickstand legs that come out. There are these little rubber feet. I don't know if you can see this on the camera. There's these little rubber feet on the bottom, and you kind of prop it up on the table next to your 3D printer. Now, I think that Creality could have come out with a number of alternative options for that. I think that there are a couple of mounting options that could have been done that would have been better than this. That's my personal opinion. If you disagree with that, I'd love to hear about it in the comments. But I came up with a 3D printed mounting option for the Sonic Pad. I have a relatively small place, and my 3D printer is right up there on that shelf. And, you know, I don't really have any room there to put the Sonic Pad. So I'm thinking to myself, well, what the hell am I gonna do? So I designed a 3D printable mount for the Sonic Pad that will let you connect it to the underside of a shelf or a table or whatever it is, wherever you have your 3D printer. And it'll make things a lot easier for you. It rotates 90 degrees and locks in. You insert the legs into these little sockets and you lock the Sonic Pad into the mount. And that way your Sonic Pad is mounted directly next to your printer in a secure way. If you guys are interested in picking that up, I left a link for the STL file down in the description. Okay guys, so now I'm gonna get into who I think this product is for. This product, in my personal opinion, is for people who are intermediate at 3D printing and own a Creality printer. I do not think that this product is gonna be good for you if A, you're a real beginner, because there is a learning curve here. B, if you're really advanced, because I'm sure there are multiple options and you probably already have a Raspberry Pi or even a laptop or a whole PC connected to multiple 3D printers and a running clipper on all of them. I understand that. This product is not for those guys. This product is for people who have Creality printers, possibly for people who don't have Creality printers. If you know how to manipulate the software, the firmware, that might be for you. It's not as plug and play for non-Creality printers. However, it is obvious, it is still usable, 100% usable for non-Creality printers. But I think that this product is designed and best suited for people who are intermediate at 3D printing, want to upgrade their printers on a budget, that don't necessarily have the know-how to use or the budget to use Raspberry Pi. I also personally think that this is a better option than a Raspberry Pi running clipper. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and I'd love to hear in the comments what other videos you guys would like me to make. I'm relatively new at YouTube. I really hope that you enjoyed this. If you did, that's great. Let me know, and let me know what other kinds of content you'd like me to get into. Anyway, that's all for now, guys. All right, take care. Bye-bye.